अस्सलामु अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। अल्हम्दुलिल्लाहि रब्बिल आलमीन वस्सलातु वस्सलामु अला अशरफिल अंबियाई वल मुरसलीन व अला आलिही व अस्हाबिही अजमाइन। अल्लाहुम्मा जअलना मिनहुम मिनल्लज़ीना आमनु व अमिलुस्सालिहाति व तवासौ बिल हक्की व तवासौ बिस सब्र। आमीन या रब्बिल आलमीन। ثم أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب
ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربي زدنا علما اللهم فقهنا في الدين اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما اللهم ثبتنا عند الموت بلا اله الا الله امين يا رب العالمين. Today I have spent all day checking students homework in their subgroups. I am part of each and every subgroup now. Some groups are doing an amazing job while other are as quiet as normal is there. Through this course, we are not only learning Arabic grammar, but I wish we learn how to be organized and be more productive in our lives. I'm 100% sure that each one of you has the ability to do homework, but it's a matter of priority. Make the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your priority number one, and believe me, everything will fall in order by the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. He will make your affairs easier for you when you spend time in His way. Attending these classes, doing homework, listening to the recordings, this all will be your ibadah, inshallah. So please keep up your hard work and you will reap the fruit of closeness of your Rabb very soon, inshallah. Today we are going to talk about another harfu nasab fragment. If you guys remember, yesterday we were talking about harfu jar fragment. And what was that harfu jar fragment? That there are 11 harf which makes next ism in jarin status. And what are they? Ba, ta, kaf, lam, waw, min, fi, an, ala, hatta, ila. And since I was checking homework and there was a little bit confusion about these harf, sometimes this lam or ba, if you see in the middle of the word and you guys were thinking that, okay, this is harfu jar because it's ba over there, or the word, the big confusion was about ulil albab. So someone saw this li over there and they thought that, okay, this is harfu jar. But first of all, the translation can help you guys. If we do not have enough vocabulary and we are getting towards our understanding, so the translation always can help you. So you can see that the uli does not have any translation like we have in harfu jar as a li. Li means four. So you don't see uli is translating as four. So that can help you. So do not look in the middle of the word, but all these harfu jar, they are going to start the harf, like in, they should be in the beginning of the word, like lahu. So, and there was also a word falahu. So sometimes, yes, something can attach to it. This fa is like a connector. Like yesterday we were talking about connector. Waw is connector. The fa is also in Arabic used as a connector. So falahu. So fa, this one is connector. And then lam is our harfu jar. And then hu, the attached pronoun, is our ism majroor. So yes, this is jar majroor fragment. Ali, there is some disturbance between the sound. Is there any mic on or what? Okay. So now today we are going to talk about harfu nasab, as the name is telling us that they are harf, and their job is going to be same like harfu jar. So what was the job of harfu jar? That they make their next ism jarin status, and these harfu nasab, they are going to make next ism nasab in status. And we all know that all these harf, they are harf and they do not have any properties. For example, we say ism has four properties. Ism need to have status, number, gender, type. But these harf does not have any status. They do not have any number, gender, or type. So, but they have a job. So the job of harfu jar was to make next ism jar in status. And now the job of harfu nasab is to make next ism nasab in status. So what are these harf? So they are over here and they are less than like harfu jar were 11, but they are only 7 of them. So what are they? Inna, anna, ka anna, bi anna, laita, lakinna, la Allah. This is the order I have memorized them. So inna, anna, ka anna, bi anna, laita, lakinna, la Allah. Now what do they mean? Inna means certainly, for sure. Inna is always come. In English we are just saying certainly, for sure, but inna is very emphatic. Whenever inna came, it is kind of clearing out some doubt. So this is very emphatic. So inna is always come to clear some doubt. Something was said, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bringing inna, clearing all that doubt over there. So this inna means certainly, for sure. Anna means that, like, I thought that, we say that, right? So this anna means that. Ka anna mean as if or as though. Bi anna mean because. La Allah means so that, hopefully, maybe. So la Allah has some hope in it. Okay? So this is, that's why you can see it saying hopefully, maybe it's going to happen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, kutiba alaykum as-siyama kama kutiba lil-lazina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has hope that through that siyam, these fasting, we are going to get taqwa. So this is the purpose of fasting, that we gain taqwa. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is hoping that this fasting gonna bring us close to taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is la Allah. And then we have lakinna. Lakinna is however, we say in Urdu, lekin. So lekin means like we are kind of negating something that is said before, and then we are kind of correcting. So this is how this lakinna is. Then we have laita. Laita is a big regret. Laita is a regret when you cannot undo something. For example, in Quran Pak, in Surah Naba, the 30th juz, the first Surah Naba, it says, يَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. So on that day of judgment, this kafar, disbeliever, he will regret, or he will wish that he could be the like a particle of dust. So no accountable. No account like is taken from him. So, but is that possible? It's gonna happen? No. So I regret that we cannot undo anything about it. So a wish that we cannot undo. So that is later. So let's memorize these seven words. What are they? Inna, anna, ka anna, di anna, la alla, sorry, laita, la kinna, la alla. Inna, anna, ka anna, di anna, laita, la kinna, la alla. Inna, anna, ka anna, di anna, laita, la kinna, la alla. So you have to, I hope that you guys already memorized all her future. Okay, bata, kaf, lam, waw, min, fi, an, ala, hatta, ila. And now this harfu nasab. So you have to memorize them. They should be like very fluent on your tongue. Inna, anna, ka anna, bi anna, laita, lakinna, la alla. So this is how it goes. Now, what is how it gonna work? So harf of nasab makes the ism after it nasab. We said that. And now distance is okay. If you remember harfu jar, we said that they are always going to be side by side. No long distance is allowed in harfu jar fragment. But over here, sometimes it's going to happen that you have inna, and then after 5, 6, or 7 words after, you're going to find its ism. So that's going to happen. Be ready for that. And sometimes it's possibility that its ism is right sitting beside it. So both possibilities are gonna be there. So we need to remember that there is possibility that there is long distance in between them. And that's it. Okay, so now let's see more about them. Okay, another name for these inna, anna, ka anna, bi anna, laita, lakinna, la alla, you can also call them inna wa ikhwatuha, meaning inna and its sisters. So basically, this is a family of all the ladies. This inna is the older sister, and all these ones are the baby sisters. Okay, so whatever inna does, all the sisters do. So we are calling them inna wa ikhwatuha. So inna and its sisters. Now, how it's gonna work? We said that inna always wants next ism nasab in status. So now I have word inna, and now I wanna say inna mean indeed or certainly. So I wanna say certainly he is a Muslim. I'm talking about one person. And I want to say, certainly he is a Muslim. Okay, no doubt he is a Muslim. So what should I do? Can I put my inna? And we have all these our Muslimun chart. Can I say inna Muslimun? Is that the right formation? No. Because we said that inna needs something that is nasab in status. So inna is not going to be happy about un sound over here. Okay, so that is wrong. Can I put it over here? Inna Musliman? Yes, he is happy here. Okay, because inna, this is our harfu nasab, and he need a victim, which should be nasab in status, and Musliman is nasab in status. I cannot put over here either. I cannot say inna Muslimin. That would be wrong. Now, if I want to say, indeed, both of them are Muslim, I'm talking about two people now. Can I say, inna Muslimani? No. Why not? Because Muslimani, we know this is a pair. And what kind of pair it is? The rough one. This is the rough version of dualism, right? So we cannot say Muslimani. But I can put over here, Anna Muslimaini. So that would be the right choice. Now, if I want to say, indeed, they all these group of people are Muslim. No doubt about it. What should I do? Can I put it over here, Inna Muslimuna? No, because again, this is our plural rough version of ism. We can do that. So we can put over here inna muslimina. If we say inna muslimina, that would be the right choice. And same practice we can do with all these harf. Okay, so anna, let's say anna now. Where should anna go? Anna musliman, anna muslimaini, anna muslimina. These are the right choices. Okay, so this is how it works. If I want to use la'alla, so again, la'alla musliman, perhaps he is a Muslim. La'alla muslimaini, perhaps both of them are Muslim. La'alla muslimina, perhaps they all are Muslim. So this is how it's gonna work. So inna always need ism, that is nasab in status. Okay, now we know that inna is harf, and we know that these are our pronouns. Okay, and we can attach and these pronouns are ism, right? The even these independent ones and these attached ones, all of them are considered with ism. So we are learning how to make harf and ism fragments. So jar majrur fragment was also harf and ism fragment. Now even this harfu nasab fragment is harf and nasab, harf and ism fragment. So that means we have harf over here, and we can attach any ism, and we can create a harfuna subfragment, but this ism should be rough in status, that's all. So now I want to use these pronouns over here. Can I say inna huwa? Inna means certainly, huwa means he is, certainly he is. Can I say that? Can I use this huwa over here, the independent pronoun? No. Why? Because all these independent pronouns are rough in status. Okay, they are all rough in status. We cannot use them. Inna need what? Inna need something that is nasab in status. And we know that these guys can be used as a nasab or jar, but over here, we are gonna use them as a nasab. If I put them with harfu jar, then they're gonna be like making jar majrur fragment. And if I'm putting them with inna, they are making that harfu nasab fragment then. So I can say inna hu. Okay, inna hu, indeed he is. Inna huma, indeed both of them. Inna hum, indeed all of them. Inna ha, indeed her or she. Inna huma, inna hunna, inna ka, inna kuma, inna kum. So I can put inna with all these pronouns. Okay, just one thing over here, when it comes to ya mutakallim over here, then it's gonna be a little problem. What's the problem? Now we have inna, and if you remember that this ana has two versions. Remember we have e and ni, but unfortunately ni is not written over here, and I forgot to add over here. So remember I said that ana have two cousins, and he was smart. What he did, he gave e job to that he said to the e, you are always going to be der, and then he said to the ni that you are always going to be nasab. So now we need to have ni over here. Okay, now in ni, and then I put ni over here, I have almost three noons. So I have three noons. We have inna, these are two noon, and then in the ni we have two noon. I made a mistake. I should add e over here, ni over here instead of e. So ni over here. So now I have three noons. So I have a choice. Either I can say inna ni. Okay, this inna and ni, all three noons together over here, and I have a choice. I can just say inni. Both version you're gonna find in Quran Pak. Okay, you will see inna ni and inni, both of them are available. Then over here in inna, in the nahnu, same thing gonna happen. So inna, and then we're gonna attach na with it. Now we have inna na, three noons. Or we can just say inna. But you guys need to be keep that in your head. What's the difference between this inna and this inna? This inna does not have alif. So this inna mean only indeed. But this inna, that's why I would stress that you need to make it long. Say inna. So you know that, okay, this na, the nahnu na is in there. Okay, so over here the translation would be indeed we or indeed us. Okay, indeed we or us, whatever you want to say. So we have nahnu over here, but in this inna, this is simple inna, indeed only. So always keep that distinction in your head. So let's sing that song with our inna now. So it's gonna go like that. Innahu, innahuma, innahum. Innahu, innahuma, innahum. Innaha, innahuma, innahumna. Innaka, innakuma, innakum. Innaki, innakuma, innakunna. Inni, or you can say innani, innana, or inna. So both way you can try that. Then you can try with la'alla. So la'alla, what is la'alla mean? Perhaps he is, or hopefully he is, or might be he is. Like we are hoping that this person is gonna do something good, okay? So la'allahu, la'allahuma, la'allahum. La'allaha, la'allahuma, la'allahunna. La'allaka, la'allakuma, la'allakum. La'allaki, la'allakuma, la'allakunna. Now, la'alli, la'allana. So this is how it's gonna work. You can try with all of them. That inshallah is going to make you strong, okay? Maybe close the door and then do it so nobody laugh at you. Or you can involve your whole family into it so no one laugh at you. So everyone should be thinking them. Okay, so then we have some Quranic example. I hope everything is clear over here. So So not all these harfu nasab need an ism nasab in status, which could be right beside it in case of attached pronoun. So when these harfu nasab are attached with the attached pronoun over here, what's gonna happen? These guys are right beside these harf, and then we do not have to look for them anymore. Remember I said that harfu nasab and its ism can have a long distance. So sometimes you're gonna see any harfu nasab and then its victim is very far away and you have to look, okay, where it is. But in this case, when we are attaching attached pronoun with it, we are lucky, no more need to search anything. So both of them, the inna and the ism, are right beside here. So this is a good thing. So whenever you see any harfu nasab and these attached pronoun, you see that attached pronoun is attached to it, then we know that, okay, that's it. No more need to look for anything. Everything is available. Our inna is there and its victim is there. Clear, everyone? So that is a good thing, a good news for us, that whenever we have a dash pronoun with the harfu nasab, then our job is all, alhamdulillah, done already for us. Now we have some Quranic examples. So let's see. It says, Inna Allaha. In Quran Pak, try to find all these harfu nasab and you will see that you will never find Inna Allahu or Inna Allahi. You will always, always find Inna Allaha. So indeed, Allah is. Certainly, Allah is. Okay? And how we are going to label it? This is really important. And right labeling, proper labeling, if you are doing it from the day one, inshallah, that is going to make you strong. Because sometimes, even the people are learning this language from many, many years, but they are not good at labeling. So this is also a very important step. That's why I always try I put everything over there for you so you can see how you are going to label it for as an example. So whenever you are doing your homework, always refer to my example. How did I label it? So now over here, how I'm gonna label that? I'm gonna say inna harfu nasab wa lafzul jalalati. Okay, this word Allah. Out of respect, we say that this is lafzu jalalati. If it is hard on your tongue, first of all, I would say that you need to try it. But if in the beginning it is hard for you, then you can just say the word Allah is ismu inna. Okay? So how are you going to say that? You're going to say inna harfu nasab. And the word Allah is ismu inna. Or you're going to say inna is harfu nasab. Wa lafzu jalalati, and the word Allah is ismu inna. Even you can say in English, inna harfu nasab, and the word Allah is its ism. Remember, always we're going to use the word Allah. We're not going to say the Allah is its ism. Okay, never say that. The word Allah is its ism. So this is how you're going to label that. Okay, now next, we have annahum. Okay, we already did that. Anna, we know that this is our harfu jar and whom is attached to it. Our job is done. They are side by side. So anna, how are we going to label? Anna harfu nasab wa hum is ismu anna. Okay, so you can say this hum is ismu inna. If, okay, now, whatever is over there, you're going to say the ism, that ism is the ism of this harf. For example, if I say ka'anna over here, let's imagine there was ka'anna. So I'm going to say ka'anna is harfu nasab and hum is ismu ka'anna. So I'm saying that this word is ka'anna hum. Okay, instead of anna hum, this word is ka'anna hum. We are imagining. And then you're going to say, Anna is harfu nasab, wa hum is ismu ka Anna. So whatever is over here, you're going to say that is the ism of that is that harf. Okay, then in English, you can say, Anna is harfu nasab, and hum is its ism. Then we have ka Anna. Ka Anna fi uzu nehi. Waqra. Now this is very interesting. Ka'anna, we know this is our harfu nasab. Okay, there is our ismu ka'anna. Now look at the word. Is that fi our ismu ka'anna? No. Why not? Because fi is harfu jar. Okay, and that harf cannot be ism of ka'anna, as we are saying ism, so that means we need an ism, and this fi is not ism, this is harf. Okay, now look at the next word, uzune. Now we know that whenever we have harfu jar, Harfujar, Need, and Ism. Okay, so that means this Uzu Nehi, this Ism, even these are two words. It's not one word, okay? So this Fi has taken this, I should say, the fragment. This is also a fragment. And inshallah, we are going to learn about this fragment too, inshallah, today. So that means this is already taken, right? Because the Fi is attached to it, and we cannot take that. Now look at the next word, Waqran. Now for God's sake, do not think, okay, this Waw is Harfu Jar. Okay? Because wherever, even though sometimes some these Waw or Ba, Ta, Kaf, they can be part of some word too. Right? So always look at the translation. Translation can help you. So Waqran is one word. Okay, and Waqran means barrier, some wheel, restriction in between. So it's as Ka'anna fi uzunaihi Waqran. Now, what do you think about Waqran? It has unsound, okay? So this is nasab in status. Look like this is perfect for our Ka'anna. So look over here. Ka'anna Waqran, basically. Ka'anna Waqran. Even we can, and just to show you guys how it works, it was like something came in between Ka'anna and Waqran, but we can think like that. It could be Ka'anna Waqran fi uzunaihi. So Ka'anna Waqran means there is a barrier fi uzunaihi in their ears. Okay, so as though, Ka'anna mean as though or as if there is a deafness, there is a barrier, there is something stuck in his ear. Okay, so this is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obviously talking about someone who does not pay attention to his reminders. So now the interesting thing is over here, uzunai. So I have breakdown over here. So uzunu, we are translating ears, right? So uzunun mean ears. Uzunan is our nasab. Uzunin is our jar. Then uzunani, our two ears. Uzunaini, right? And then how do we make light? Uzunaini, I want to make this light. How I can do that? Easy, I need to drop this noon. Now I have uzunai. Okay, so this is our uzunai. And then I attach pronoun to that. And now that makes it his ears. Okay, and then I'm saying his ears, what I'm doing? I'm kind of creating like possession word, right? Ears of his ears. And inshallah, we are going to learn about it. This is called Idafa fragment. And we are going to learn about that too, inshallah. So this is how it is. So sometimes, these ism of all these harfu nasab gonna be far away. Something gonna come in between it. But we should know that, okay, we need to look for something that is nasab in status and we can easily spot it. So the Ka'anna's ism is Waqran. Then we have Zalika bi annahum qalu. Zalika, that is bi annahum, bi anna mean because they qalu said. So now bi anna is our harfu nasab and I have attached pronoun. Perfect, okay, job done. So now I can say that, okay, and whom is ismu bi anna. Okay, remember I'm not saying it, this is ismu inna or anna or ka'anna, but bi anna. Why? Because this is bi anna over here. Then we have leita. Laita, I told you already, Laita is a regret that we cannot do undo. Like, we cannot do anything about it. It's done. It cannot be undo. So, ya vailata laitani lam attakhiz fulanan khalila. This is very scary ayah. It says someone is cursing himself on the day of judgment. And he's saying that if only I did not take so and so for as a friend. Fulanan, so and so, khalilan, as a friend. So someone is regretting on the day of judgment because his friends were not good. They were not a good influence. That's why he was all spent his life all in a misleading way. And now he has a big regret on the day of judgment that he should not follow his friends. So this is really important that we need to keep a good company. So we do not have any kind of regret, inshallah. So now, laita ni. Okay, laita, we already know. Inna, anna, ka anna, bi anna, laita. Laita is our part of list. So this is laita and then ni. Okay, this is our ana version. This is nasa version. So that means job is done. We have laita and ni is our isam of laita. Then we have lakinna. Lakin al birra. Okay, again I can see birra. So this fatha is telling me that this is nasab. So perfect match. So lakinna is our harfu nasab and birra is our ismu lakinna. So you can say in English lakinna harfu nasab and birra, not birru. I think this typo here. So birra is its ism. Then we have la'alla. La'alla kum tashkurun. So la'alla is our harfu nasab. And this kum attached pronoun, job easy. Okay, so this is our ismu, la'alla. And tashkurun means, so you be, Allah is hoping that you be grateful to him. So these are some Quranic examples. I'm hoping that things are getting clear to you guys. And now, even though I already explained, but let's see one more time over here. So all these harfu nasab need an ism, nasab in status, which could be right beside it in the case of attached pronoun. It can be far apart from it. So look for an ism, nasab in status. So over here, what's going on? As I said before, inna, inna, anna, ka anna, bi anna, all of them. What happened when we put ni beside it? Now we have three noons and now we have a choice. Either we can say inna ni, we can have all these three noons, or we can just say inni. Okay? But when we say inni, we still need to know, okay, this I is in there. Now, same thing here, bi anna, and then with na with nahnu. So we can say bi anna na or bi anna. Both ways fine. And you will find that in Quran Pak too. So I think that is making sense to you guys. And now this is the homework regarding to our harfu nasab. At the end of this homework, I kind of label everything down in case you guys are struggling. So first you're gonna try yourself. And even if we have time today at the end of the class, so maybe we can do a few of them. But if we didn't left any time, then you guys are going to try that. Do not open the key unless you are done your homework, like you're done this page. Once you are done, you try your best, then you're gonna look at it and see if that was making sense. Okay, so I'm gonna leave that alone now. Now we have idafa fragment. Okay, idafa fragment is very interesting concept in Arabic grammar. If you guys remember, in the beginning of our class, I told you, maybe first or second lesson, that there is no word for articles in Arabic. So we use either tanween when we want to say a Muslim, I'm going to say Muslimun. Or if I want to say the Muslim, I need to put al. So this is how we we use the articles in Arabic. So tanween or al. Now I'm going to tell you today that in Arabic, there is no word for off. Okay, so we do not have any word for off in Arabic. But we need to, and off, we know that we want to say something, someone, something or someone belong, something belong to something, right? So when I say house of Allah, Rasul of Allah, right? So the Rasul belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So off, when I want to say off in Arabic, I need to make some changes in these two isms. And again, this idafa fragment is going to happen between two isms. So far, we learned harfu jar and harfu nasab fragment. These two fragments were happening between harf and ism. But this is the first fragment we are learning that is happening between two isms. Okay, so this is a relation. Idafa fragment is a relation between two fragments. And to create this, the word of in between, we need to make some changes in these two isms. Okay, so let's see. An idafa is a fragment which brings two isms together with the word of in between them. For example, messenger of Allah, friend of mine, imam of a masjid. In Arabic, the word before of is called mudaf, and the word after of is called mudaf ilayhi. Now, the primary rules of the idafa are the mudaf, which is word before of, should be light, no alif lam. And the mudaf ilayhi should be in jar status, and it should come after mudaf. No long distance relationship, nothing comes between mudaf and its mudaf ilayhi. The last property of mudaf, like its type, is dictated by mudaf ilayhi. Okay, bear with me, and inshallah, in next slide, everything is going to be clear. Just try to absorb what I'm saying over here. Then how we can create idafa fragment? There are three ways we can create idafa fragment. The one way is that we need to bring this off, and inshallah, I'm gonna explain how we're gonna bring this off. Then another way is that we can just add the attached pronoun with it. Okay, so you take any ism and you attach a pronoun with it, and now you have idafa fragment. If you guys remember, we were singing the other day, Rabbuhu, Rabbuhuma, Rabbuhum. What we were doing? So I added hu with Rab, and now I have I'm saying Rabbuhu, his Rab. So this is our idafa fragment. I'm saying Rabbuhuma, both of their Rab. So now this is our idafa fragment. Rabbuhum, this is our idafa fragment. So we already know this fragment already. I'm gonna just telling name today. So actually part of this idafa fragment, you already know. Then we have third way to make idafa fragment is there are some, I'm gonna share the list with you guys. There are some special mudaf, okay? And when they come, they create idafa fragment. Like for example, taht al-ardi mean underneath the earth. Now, these special mudaf are basically zarf. What is zarf mean? Like we use the time words and we use place words. Like place words, I meant when we say something is above something, something is behind, something is beside you, right? So these are all the things that the words that are describing some place, something is where, right? Or we say yesterday or in the morning. So these are time words. So these time words and these place words, we are calling them special mudaf. Why? Because they are mudaf, they come as a mudaf, and they have mudaf ilayhi, which is jar in status, but we do not have av in between them. In the translation, you will not see av in between them. Okay? But still, we are considering them as a mudaf ilayhi. So inshallah, let me explain in the next slides, and inshallah that would be clear. So look over here in the picture, that might help you. So again, three ways we can create a dafa fragment. The first thing is we need to bring up. How we need to bring up? Inshallah, we are going to learn Imamul Masjidi. Okay, we are saying the Imam of the Masjid. Now, Baituhu, his house, or house of his, right? So we have created idafa this way. Or these time words and these place words, they are going to create idafa fragments too. So these are the three ways that we can create idafa fragment. Okay, now look at the example over here. How are we going to create of between two ism? Now I have two ism over here. I have the word Baitun, and then I have the word Allahu. Okay, these are two different words. They are not related anywhere to each other. Okay, they are not making any sentence. They are not making any fragment. They are two separate words, Baitun and the word Allahu. Now I want to say the house of Allah. Okay, I want to say house of Allah. Now what I have to do, the first word, the first ism, okay, what is the name of the first ism? It is called mudaf. So this first ism, I need to make it light. So this first ism cannot have tanween, and it cannot have al. Two things you need to remember, that's all. So this first ism cannot have al, cannot have tanween. So that's why now there wasn't any al. Okay, so I'm happy. One thing is out of my way already. Now I have un sound over here. I'm going to just drop one harika, and I have baitu. This is perfect for my mudaf. Now the next condition for the next ism, the only one condition. This the first ism has two conditions. What are these two conditions? It cannot have tanween, it cannot have al. Okay, say five times. The first ism, which is called mudaf cannot have tanween, mudaf cannot have al. One more time. Mudaf cannot have al, mudaf cannot have tanween. Mudaf cannot have al, mudaf cannot have tanween. Mudaf cannot have al, mudaf cannot have tanween. Okay? Now, our second ism, it has only one condition. What is the condition of that ism? Always jar. That's it. Nothing else. Okay? So some light by dropping the one harika. And I put on the second ism E sound, and I have created of in between it. So I'm saying Baitullahi, house of Allah. Okay, house of Allah. Okay, why I'm saying the house of Allah? I'm gonna explain in a bit. Do not want to put too much. First, let's make this concept clear, and then I'm going to explain why da is written over here. Okay, so Baitullahi, the house of Allah. Now look at the second example. I have the word Rabbun. Okay. As-samawatu. Separate two ism. They do not have any relation. Now I want to say the Lord of the heaven. Okay. The Rabb of the skies. I want to create a in between. What should I do? My first step. I need to make this first ism light. It has the mean on it. Okay. So I'm going to say, instead of Rabbun, I'm going to say Rabbu. I made it light. One job is done. Now, my second ism, which is called Mudaf Ilayhi, it need to be Jarin status. Okay. So, As-samawatun, As-samawatu, As-samawati, right? Muslimatu, Muslimati, right? So, Nasab and Jar status, both are same. So, As-samawati. So, I'm going to have my Jar status of As-samawati, and now I have created a in between, and I'm going to say, the Lord of the heavens and the earth. So basically what is going on over here, this Rab is my Mudaf and this As-samawati wal ardi. Now these guys have two Mudaf ilayhi. That can happen. So instead of one Mudaf, Waw came. Okay, Waw is a connector, meaning whatever was before, is it, this is connected to the this ism. So that means this As-samawati, the whole thing is my Mudaf Ilayhi, because they are all connected with this Waw. Okay, next one. It says imamun masjidun. So again, two separate isms, imam mean imam, and masjid mean masjid. So now, I want to say imam of a masjid. Okay? So I'm going to drop this one, Harika. I have imamu. Okay? And now, masjidun, instead of masjidun, I'm going to say masjidin. And now I have imam of a masjid. Now, if you guys noticed, it's time to explain why I have the over here and I do not have the over here. Let me explain you. Now, I'm saying imamu masjidin, right? I did not put the over here. But when I say baytullahi, I'm saying the house of Allah. What's going on here? How do we say something when we want to say particular, like the house? In Arabic, we add al, right? So I have baytun, and then I want to say, baytun mean a house, and then I want to say da house, I need to say al baytu, right? I add al. But what happened, we said that our mudaf cannot have al. So if this guy, the poor guy, cannot have al, how we can have, if we want to say da, what we going to do then? Okay, the problem is going to be solved because the job is assigned to that next ism now. If next ism is proper, like this guy has al, then this guy automatically going to get al. Okay, so the word Allah is proper, right? This is the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is proper. So that's why I have the house of Allah over here. But over here, I have imamu masjidin. Did I put al over here? Al masjidin? Al masjidi? No, right? So imamu masjidin. Now this masjid does not have al. It's not proper. Masjidin is common. So that's why I'm saying Imam of a masjid. If I put al over here, if I say Imamu al-Masjidi, remember with al and tanween, I cannot say together, right? I cannot say al-Masjidin, that would be wrong. There would be a disaster here. So I cannot, when I say al, I need to have drop one haraka already. So imamu, imamul masjidi, if I put al over here, what gonna be translation then? The imam of the masjid. Okay, so this is how this da comes. Now over here, next example, qawmu Musa. Okay, now that was qawmun and Musa. Now I created idafa fragment. I said qawmu Musa. Now we know that Musa is a name of a prophet, right? So that's why da is coming, because now this guy, this mudaf ilayhi is proper, and this is making this qawm proper. So that's why we are saying the nation of Musa al-Islam. Same thing happening over here, Ibnun Maryamun. Ibn means son, and Maryamun is Maryam. So now, Ibnun Maryama. Ibnun Maryama. Why Maryama? Because we know that Maryama is partly flexible word. It is not going to take us at all. Okay? So that's why it is Ibnu Maryama, the son of Maryam al-Islam. Ali? Ali, there is again something with sound in my Bluetooth. Should I remove my Bluetooth then?
Okay, so now we have Ibnu Maryama. So the son of Maryam al-Islam. Now look at the next example, Bani Israila. Okay, basically it was Banina Israilu, if I look at separately. So that is Banun is the plural, and then Banuna, Banina, Banina. This is how it works. And now Banina Israilu, these are the two isam. Now I want to say the sons of Israel. What I should do, I need to make this Banin light. So how do we make it light? We drop this noon. Remember, we just do all this how to make light just for this guy. Okay, just for this mudaf. This is the only reason that we learn how to make isam light. Okay, so there is connection between what we were learning before. So this is Banina, we drop this noon. Now we have Bani, and then Israila. Again, we cannot say Israili. This is partly flexible, right? So we need to say Israila. So Bani Israila, the son of Israel. Okay, then we have Muslimuna Makkata. Okay. Muslimuna mean Muslims, and Makkah is Makkah. Now I want to say the Muslims of Makkah. Okay. Now Muslimuna, I need to make this light. Muslimu, and then Makkata. Since Makkata is a proper name of a place, that's why I'm saying the Muslims of Makkah. Then we have Rabbu and Na. I attached my Na with Rab, and I got Rabbuna. And this is another way to create idafa fragment. Okay. So now the thing to remember is when we attach an attached pronoun with harfu jar, we always get what? Jar wa majroor. So fihi, minhu, lahu, alayhi, alayhim, alaykum. Okay. Whatever we find in our homework today, these were all attached pronoun with harfu jar, and they were creating jar majroor fragment. And today we learned that when we attach an attached pronoun with an ism, we always get what? Idafa fragment. So we have Rabbu, we attached attached pronoun with it, and now we got idafa fragment, Rabbuhu. Okay, this is very important things to remember. Whenever you have attached pronoun attached to some harfu jar, you're gonna always get jar majroor fragment. And when attached pronoun attached with an ism, you always get idafa fragment. Okay, so that was it. And how we are going to label that? Again, I told you guys that first guy gonna call mudaf, the second guy gonna call mudaf ilayhi. So this is how you're gonna label it. Our baitu is mudaf, and the word Allah is mudaf ilayhi. Rabbu is our mudaf, as-samawati wal ardi is mudaf ilayhi. Now you guys should remember, one mudaf can have multiple mudaf ilayhi. Okay, even if I put waw over here and I keep adding ism over here, then this rab gonna have, this mudaf gonna have more mudaf ilayhi. Okay, so this is how it works. Then we have imamu masjidin. So imamu is our mudaf, masjidin is our mudaf ilayhi. Okay, so this is how it works. And over here, one more time, I explained how this da works. So let's see. Point to be noted that we make something proper by adding an al before it, right? But mudaf cannot have al. So whether mudaf is proper or common depends on mudaf ilayhi. So for example, over here, baytullahi, da house of Allah. Why da? Because the word Allah, the mudaf ilayhi, was proper, and that's why we are making this mudaf proper. Imamu masjidin, imam of masjid. So that was common. So that's why you don't see da over here. But if I say imamul masjidi, now the translation is da imam of the masjid. So this is how it works. Okay. Now one more time, just kind of revealing that a summary of it, that idafa shows possession. Mudaf and mudaf ilayhi, these are the two components of idafa fragment. Mudaf is always light, no alif lam, and followed by jar, meaning this mudaf ilayhi is going to be jar. And you can look at this example over here, this picture. Okay, so mudaf, always light, no tanmeen, mudaf ilayhi, followed by jarism. And this is how we create idafa fragment. No long distance, okay? They are always going to be side by side. And type of mudaf is going to describe by the mudaf ilayhi. Okay, either this mudaf is gonna get da or not, that gonna decide mudaf ilayhi. Okay, so that was it. Now that time and place, the place words, these are the words that I was talking about, they are called zarf. Okay, these words remain mansub, like unless harfu jar comes before them. Okay, for these ones over here, you guys can see fauka gonna remain fauka when min gonna come over here, then it gonna be min fauki. Okay, min tahti, min badi, min qabli. Okay, so something gonna come, then they are going to be like jar. If harfu jar comes, it gonna be in jar status, otherwise it gonna remain like that. And we have to kind of memorize this list. Okay, so these are place words: fauka, above, tahta, below, bada, and then qabla over here. So these are opposite. And then imama in front of, kudama is right in front of, haula mean around, wara'a mean behind, khalfa is behind too, ma'avid, inda. Okay, so they are called word zarf because they are describing place where something is, right? So they are called place, and then we have some time related words too, right? Like yesterday, or maybe in the evening, in the morning. So they tells time, right? So these time and space, we call them zarf. But some of them you guys can see over there are not related to time. For example, ghayra. It's not related to time. It's not, ghayra mean other than. Okay. Ayya, again, it's not related to time. It says which or any. Ladun, bada, duna, kulla. So still we call them special mudaf. The one that kind of denote time and place, we call them zarf. But the other ones that are not describing time or place, we just, you guys can call them, call the special mudaf. That's it. How you guys can differentiate that. So again, these are the ones that are not time related or place related. So we can call them special mudaf. The other ones, what we're gonna call them? Zarf. So they are related to time and space. Whew. Okay, even though I put song over here, it does not look like I have energy to sing, but I can try. Okay, so this is the song which is going to help us to know like when these attached pronouns get attached to ism or harf, what do we get, okay? So this is a beautiful song. Like I like it too, how it easily make you understand the concept. So it's go like that. When the pronoun joins a noun, we get mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. When the pronoun joins a noun, we get mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. When the pronoun joins preposition, we get jarun wa majrurun. When the pronoun joins a zarf, we get zarf and mudaf ilayhi. So this is how it goes, okay? My throat is not allowing me to sing. So that is good enough, inshallah. You guys can sing, or you guys can find on YouTube. Even I shared in the groups, okay? So that is like in this YouTube clip, you can find this song too. So now what this is saying, that when a pronoun joins a noun. So this pronoun joined a noun, okay? And what did we get? Mudaf mudaf ilayhi, rabbuhu is rab. And when a pronoun joins a preposition, okay, this fi is preposition, and what do we get? We get jarun wa majrurun, jar majrur fragment. And when a pronoun joins a zarf, okay, so tahta is zarf, right? Tahta is telling something is underneath it, okay? So this is zarf. So when we attach pronoun with a zarf, what do we get? Zarf and mudaf ilayhi. So this tahta is our zarf, and this hu we're gonna call mudaf ilayhi. Even though the of is not coming in this relationship, okay, you will not find the word of in the translation, but still we call them mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Okay, so this is how it is. Okay, last thing inshallah, just a summary. The after of, or you guys can call it idafa fragment, and another name is murakkabe idafi. It will happen between two isms. Okay, it will show possession, belonging. The in Arabic there is no word for of. We have to create it. How we can create it? So we have Rasul, Lun, and the word Allah. I need to like drop on Harika. We need to make this first ism light. So I made Rasulu. And then the second ism, I need to have Jarin status. So I made it Jar, Rasulullahi. So now I have my Idafa fragment, the Rasul of Allah. Now imagine I have Al Rasulu, Ar Rasulu, and the word Allah. How I can create Idafa fragment? First of all, I need to get rid of this Al, because Mudaf cannot have Al. So I remove this Al, I have Rasulu left, and now this word Allah, I need to give it a Jar status. And now I have Idafa fragment. That's all. Okay. So I hope everything is clear. It's not, you need to at least watch this video 5 times, okay? Make sure you know everything inside out. This Idafa fragment, you're gonna find almost in every other ayah. You will find it everywhere in Quran Pak. Okay, so this is very important concept. So you guys need to get it clear. Now homework. It's saying homework number 2. Why? Because homework number 1 is already after harfu nasab. I put it over there, right? So you have that one is number 1. This one is number 2. You have to label it and you have to identify if it is idafa fragment or not. So now, kabli ka. Okay, kabli, we know, if you guys need to memorize that list, okay? So kabli is part of our special mudaf. So yes, this is our idafa fragment. Kabli is our special mudaf, and this ka is our mudaf ilayhi. So this is our idafa fragment. Now over here, humul muflihona. Okay, now the pronouns cannot be mudaf. Keep that in your head. Also, second word, muflihun, do you think it is jar? No, this is rafa in status. So that does not qualify for our mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Okay. Now, ba'da al-yawma. So ba'da, again, this is part of our special mudaf list. So yes, this is our mudaf. And then you're going to look at the next ism. This is yawmi. So this is perfect mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Kullaha is also part of our special mudaf. And then ma'a is also part of our special mudaf. Okay. And rest is easy. I think almost we covered it. Now, asma'i haulai, that can be tricky. So asma'i, you guys can see this is light. Okay. And then haulai, even though haulai remains haulai in all these status, but it looks like it is jarin status, right? So names of those, that translation is names of those. Okay, so that can help you, name of those. So of is coming, so this is our idafa fragment. Okay, so that was homework number 2. Then we have 3 over here. Okay, so let's see if we have anything here. So again, you need to find idafa fragment. Look over here. Asfin ma'kulin. Okay, asfin Makul, and do you think this is our, that could this guy qualify for our mudaf? No, because there is in sound. This is heavy, right? So that cannot. So you guys are going to listen to it, listen to the recording, look at the lesson plan, try to understand completely before you start attempting your homework. Do not rush. And do not rush to ask question two. First, you need to make sure that you are just watching recording once is not gonna help you. At least if you are very genius, at least twice, I would recommend that two times you need to watch the recording, listen to it, and then try to attempt your homework. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.